I'm Larry Rice, Director of the New Life Evangelistic Center. I can't stress how critical your involvement is at New Life at this moment. As the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America that provides for hundreds of people every day with food and shelter, your involvement at this moment is absolutely essential. That's why I'm asking you to please stay tuned as we hear from some of the people you're helping and how your prayers are urgently needed at this hour. I want to thank each and every one of you that are praying during this very difficult time for the New Life Evangelistic Center. I don't know if really you've grasped, maybe you have, but a lot of people just really haven't demonstrated that they've grasped the reality of what's happening out there and how difficult it is for those that find themselves in a situation without any hope at all because they don't have a home. So we want to infuse hope in their life by letting them know that God loves them, cares about them, not just telling them that, but providing them with a place to sleep at night. Now, Tammy is one of those. Her and her husband are homeless. Is that correct?
Yes. We became homeless due to bad choices. We were both drug addicts and alcoholics and not living right. And, you know, even though we had an income each, we weren't giving it to the Lord. And, you know, God's hand is not short. He's reaching back to draw us back to Him. And we're back with the Lord thanks to the New Life Evangelistic Center. And I thank God that I am 3 weeks clean, sober, and my husband is. And, you know, you just want to keep giving. When people give to you, you want to give to others. I've seen people that have nothing here, and you have clothed people, fed them, prayed for them. Religion is not pushed on anyone here. I have not been happy like this in so many years. I've lost a lot of family members. I have so much to be thankful for. And my life was going just down a grease sliding board to hell. And I thank God every day that He pulled me out of that miry clay, and He has given my husband and I another chance. And we have New Life, and that's the name, New Life. So, you know, everybody, I hope they just keep praying and donating any clothing, food, any way they could help, the prayers, interceding, because I know God's got His hand on my life and He's got His hand on your life, Reverend Rice, and I am just blessed and I thank God that I'm here.
And I thank God for those of you that have realized the urgency of the hour and are sharing those much needed financial gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center at this critical hour. We must do everything we can to continue to keep this facility open. We need a financial miracle at this moment. We need all of you praying as we continue to strive to be good neighbors and at the same time not turn anyone who's homeless and hurting away. How I thank God for those of you that are getting involved in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center at this hour. It is a very difficult time and one in which we need all of you to pray. But greater is He who's in us than he that is in the world. Tammy, I appreciate your honesty about how you want to get back right with God.
Oh, yes.
Because you know, you make wrong choices, mm-hmm. it can totally destroy you. Some would get very critical when people do that. But, hey, that's not the story of Jesus mm-hmm. and the prodigal son and so many stories throughout the Scriptures. When they come back, we're supposed to welcome them and have a place for them. And that's why it's important all of you get behind the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. We must keep this place open, don't we?
Yes, we need this place to stay open. I suffer with mental illness. My husband does. And when I didn't have any place to go from the hospital, the caseworkers say, Larry Rice will always open his doors for you. And they did.
And we want to continue to keep those doors open. Mm-hmm. At this time, I want to go to Bernie Hayes and Rita Days. And as they interact, as they share, please get involved in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Please share with your church and on the job and everywhere, letting individuals know that they are needed at this mm-hmm. moment here at New Life. And we need them to share those much-needed tax-deductible gifts now at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. And give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org.
Hello, I am Bernie Hayes, and my guest is the director of the St. Louis County Election Board, Mrs. Rita Days. Welcome.
Thank you.
You know, you've been around for enough time to know the ins and outs of politics and the ins and outs of the importance of elections, the ins and outs of the importance of being a woman, and the ins and outs of being a faithful person. So I'd like to ask about Rita Hurd Days. What's important in your life?
Family is first.
Okay.
Family is always first. I have one son, two daughters, and they are all in their various avocations. My two of my children are actually teachers in the public school system, and I'm extremely proud of that. They we have too many folks that are in education that really don't have a passion about it, and
sure.
and both of them do have a passion about education and making sure that the children get what they need. My daughter-in-law is also an educator. I came from a long line of educators, and I kind of broke that mold coming up here, being a full-time mom initially, and then getting into politics. No one else in my family has ever been into politics, but family is indeed first. I have another daughter who is in Atlanta now, and she's working with AT&T, and she's doing very well and likes it. So that's really, it's as you say, I had one opportunity to make sure that my children grew up to be responsible citizens and sensitive, and I think that I have accomplished that. And it's not easy, but it is it's a very rewarding when you know that they turn out to be okay.
When we were speaking earlier today, you were mentioning that you watch Channel 24. You're a fan of Channel 24, which is very nice.
Yeah, I don't get a lot of TV because it's during the day I'm working, and in the evenings I have other obligations as well. But after the 10 o'clock news, and I turn on to 24 because I really get tired of looking at the crime and
sure.
you know all that other stuff, and so I can look at something that I know is going to have a good ending. And that Sergeant Preston, they used to have the Long Ranger on, and you know I'm looking at all that, and I go to sleep with a peaceful mind,
sure.
You know. That the bad guys did not win, the good guys won, and so that's really important to me. I do watch that quite a bit, and then afterwards, of course, Reverend Rice comes on with his messages, and
sure.
but it's very very refreshing to know that there are still things on television that that are good stories, and I like that.
And your faith, you're so faithful. I see you at different churches. You go to different churches all the time. Tell us about your faith.
Well, my faith is basically rooted years ago. My grandfather, a Methodist minister, and he and my grandmother moved around a lot, and my mother did even as a young child, because as you know, in the Methodist Church, it depends on the conference and where the conference
sure.
sends you, and that's where you go. But the church is actually I grew up the foundation of the community, and so whatever you had to do, whatever was going on, it was always rooted in the church and the school, of course. But I do visit a lot of churches here in the St. Louis area just to get a different flavor for what's going on. But I actually am a member of New Sunny Mount Missionary Baptist Church with Reverend Hunter.
Donald Hunter is
my pastor, yes.
And you're a former state senator, and you're doing so well. You and Paula Carter used to be guests on my program, my radio program. And term limits came out, you know, and so many people lost their positions because of term limits. How do you feel about term limits?
Well, I think that every election, the citizens who voted me in have an opportunity to vote me out. If they don't like what I'm doing, if they don't like the way the legislature was going at the time, they held me responsible for that. But I think you took that responsibility away from my constituents, because now, whether they liked me or not, or whether I was doing a good job or not, at a specific amount of time, I was termed out.
Yeah.
And so many people voted for that now that they know that many of the people that really were significant in terms of legislation and significant in terms of their process and getting them what they needed were no longer there. And I didn't think I really was trying to term you out, but you know, the whole body. And so you serve 8 years in each house, and in Missouri, it's a permanent ban. So there will be no opportunity for me to go back and run again. In some states, they do have that. You sit out a few years and then you can go back, but not in Missouri. Mm-hmm. And it's also in the Constitution, which the folks who purported this issue were very smart about putting it in the Constitution, because it's very difficult to take something out of the Constitution once it's been voted in.
And they took something good away from the people. I mean, your constituents were really outdone when you were termed out, and other people in the St. Louis area were termed out. What's the importance of elections? You're the director of elections for the St. Louis County. What is the importance of registering to vote and actually voting?
This is the one time, one and maybe the only time, that you are stand shoulders to shoulders with anyone else in this community. You, the president, the senators, you have one vote. Everyone has one vote, and your vote is just as important as any of those other people. And so you go out and you voice your opinion, and you voice your opinion by your vote. Who do you think should represent you in whatever body it is, whether it's the Senate, the president? You make that decision. And so you, and collectively with all the others, you decide that, you know, I want President Obama, I want, right now we have Roy Blunt, and we have Senator McCaskill. So you make those decisions. And collectively, that is power in itself. And so I really think the power is in the vote. And not just because I'm here in this position. I know many years ago when we did not have that collective power. Mm-hmm. And so now we do have it, we need to exercise that.
I don't think I've ever had put it like that before. You're saying that by your vote, you are equal to anyone else.
Absolutely.
To the president or to the governor, to the mayor.
That's exactly right. There is, when you cast that vote, we have no idea who cast that vote. And so yours goes in with everybody else's, and we come out and count them at the end of the day, and then that decision is made. So mm-hmm. it really is. It's empowering. And we need to make sure that in our community particularly, that we use that to empower ourselves to make the change that we want to make.
The New Life Evangelistic Center is in danger of losing its operating license to homeless people. And there are some people who are very close proximity to here, some condos, who don't want the New Life to be here because they don't want to look out their windows and see poor people. Any thoughts on that?
Well, poor people have been around in this country since its inception. There are the haves and the have-nots. There has always been. But I do know that the New Life Evangelistic Center was housed here long before the renaissance of the city, long mm-hmm. before they renovated and have all the nice expensive lofts and the new generation coming in, and they were here first. And so I think that should be in itself allowed to continue, because you knew that when you moved in. And I'm not disparaging the people who move in. Absolutely, I understand that you have property values that you want to maintain. But we also have to look at the less fortunate that we are. Where would you suggest that the less fortunate be? And perhaps if you were maybe a little more generous, we might not have as many people who are less fortunate, and maybe it would not be necessary. But right now, I think it is. And I think they do a wonderful job of making sure that the homeless are not just abandoned.
Rita Hurd Days, Director of the Elections for St. Louis County, and I want to thank you for visiting with us here at New Life Evangelistic Center.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
I want to thank each and every one of you for viewing us too, and we hope that you'll continue to support the New Life Evangelistic Center, Reverend Rice, and all the ministers and ministries here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. I'm Bernie Hayes. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, Bernie and Rita. Now, we do need the prayers of each and every one of you at this time. Yes, we are under the great attack at this moment, and the pressure continues to be there. The financial needs continue to exist, but hey, it's not a time for us to give up. We've got to give it to God. There's too many people in need. Too many of God's children are facing critical needs at this time, and they only have New Life Evangelistic Center to come to, the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America. Tell us your name, sir.
Kevin.
Kevin, how important was it to you this place was open to you?
It was very important because I found myself out in the cold, hungry, no money, no food, no clean clothes. And when I found New Life Evangelistic Center, I got an opportunity for shelter, a shower, and a good community place where people were friendly, nice, welcoming, and just all out good people.
Was it a gateway to a new life for you? Is it opening up a new life for you?
Yeah, it's opened up a new life and new doors, new opportunity to meet people and network and look for jobs and housing and make new friends.
How'd you find out about the place?
I was looking through an employment guide, and there it was. So I called the number, and they said, come on right in. Be down here, and you're welcome.
Do you feel like it's helping you draw closer to God?
Yes.
How?
Well, at first I didn't pray much, and I didn't feel as much happiness and joy that I feel now. And being here, being around good-spirited people raises my spirits, and it makes me feel worthwhile on accomplishing new goals.
Yes, and getting into God's Word and knowing that He is there with you and that you're not alone.
Yes.
That Jeremiah 33 says, He says, ask and I will show you great and mighty things. And so in the midst of the need, many are asking the Lord. And as they come to New Life Evangelistic Centers, we work in partnership with local churches and groups all over. Brothers and sisters, we're not in competition. We're in cooperation. We're co-workers in the kingdom. You are a part of that co-working relationships. You are absolutely critical at this time in your involvement with your prayers, your volunteer efforts, your gifts. You are needed here at New Life Evangelistic Center. New Life Evangelistic Center receives no United Way funding, no city, state, or federal dollars. How can we meet the need? Except through each one of you that are going to God in earnest prayer at this time. You Club 24 members that are faithfully sharing that $24 a month, representing 24 hours a day, New Life Evangelistic Centers in Action. Those of you that are sharing those special gifts with us, so urgently needed now as we approach Thanksgiving. We have so many people coming to us for food and so many more for shelter. Are you thankful for the food you eat daily, for the shelter that you have? Then will you share a much needed gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center? I believe God is speaking to someone's heart to take a step of faith, to express their thankfulness, share a gift of $1,000, which is urgently needed this time with New Life Evangelistic Center. P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. We do need to hear from you at this very, very critical moment. The need is great, and we want everyone to know that there is hope. Christ is risen. Have you actually slept outside?
Yes.
Where did you sleep?
Well, I slept down the street in this park, and it wasn't too pleasant. It wasn't too nice.
Did people bother you?
I mean, the noise and people walking by, and then the cold air, that, yes.
Can you imagine if a New Life did not fight the principalities and powers and did not persevere and remaining open, what would happen if you'd had to sleep out there this winter and it got down to 20 degrees?
I don't think it would be so good. I don't think it'd be nice.
And that's why we are so fervently working to continue to keep New Life Evangelistic Center open and its shelters open throughout Mid-America. Not only do we have the legal expense to continue to resist those fiery darts, even one that would love to just wipe us out, stop us from sheltering. We also have the maintenance costs that are involved. We have the extra expenses that are involved as we move into the cold weather right now, trying to help people and feed people and clothe people and shelter individuals as we move into Thanksgiving. And we really do need your help. And I thank God for those of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center right now. And those of you that are volunteering, our volunteers are such a blessing.
Hi, I'm Cindy Chung. We're a family of five. We thought it might be a special treat to share what we have with others. We are very grateful for the opportunity, and I know that this will be a great learning lesson for gratitude, for sharing for all of us. Thank you.
Hi, this is Yongju Chung, father of three children. I'd like to take this opportunity to share our minds to the people who need supports, help. And we've been receiving so much from God, so we'd like to give small time or our life to help homeless people. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Venus, and I'm here to serve the poor. I think it's very important to help other people. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ashley. I just came here to really help and serve those who are in need, and we have never done anything like this before, so I'm really looking forward to help these people, and yeah, thank you.
Hi, I'm Josh Chong. I think that people should all be treated in the same way, and yet like certain people have more money, so they get more of what they want, but certain people don't have that sort of life. So we just decided to come here to help those that are in need, and to give them what they want, really, and just help them out.
Hi, my name is Dolores McCray. I'm 75 years young. I'm also a veteran. I was a nurse in the United States Air Force. I was married 46 years up until a year ago when my husband died with prostate cancer. I have 13 grandchildren, 10 great-grands. We've on occasion had to come to New Life Evangelistic Assistance Center to ask for assistance. And after following the guidelines, we did receive assistance. And we're so ever grateful. And now is the time for us to give back. That's why I continue to volunteer. My husband and I used to volunteer down here together for about 6 years. So I'm going to carry on our tradition because God has treated us well, meets all of our survival needs, and we're going to give back and help others. With hygiene kits, with the Club 24 80 cent a day, with the City of Refuge project, the women over in Calcutta, India. And we always give gifts back. You know, you just keep on giving. As people give to us, we have gifts to give back to them. You just can't be God-giving. Call us 416-2424. Give us a call. Give us a call. You might see me manning the phones one day. Come help us stuff envelopes. Come help us to reach hurting people. Cast your bread upon the waters. Trust me, at age 75, I know that God sends them back to you. If not for you, for your grandchildren and your children and all your significant others. Continue to be blessed, and I wish you success in all you do.
I thank God for those of you that have volunteered at New Life Evangelistic Center throughout the years. As we approach, again, Thanksgiving, Christmas, we're asking volunteers to come forth. Those that want to help at our 1411 Locust Dinner need to come on Sundays at 2 p.m. If they can't come then, come on Wednesdays at 2 p.m. Very important volunteer training. We need to have you there. Those that are in the Springfield, Missouri area, go by our place at 806 North Jefferson, the Veterans Coming Home Center there, and discover all the things you can do there. Or contact the center close to you if you're in Potosi or Van Buren, or you happen to be at any of the locations in Joplin or Marshfield or Columbia. Please do get directly involved because you are deeply appreciated as a volunteer. And because of you faithful volunteers and because of our growing network of trainees, where we actually have an open door policy where we see the homeless not as the problem, but as part of the solution, and we give them an opportunity to help others that are in need. Every dollar you donate provides $3 worth of direct services because of the dedicated labors of our volunteers and trainees. Tammy Arnold is back with me. And Tammy, you indicated that this place has been a big help to you at this time, mm-hmm. because what would you and your husband be doing? Where would you be staying right now if the doors weren't open?
We'd probably be on the street or back into the drug addiction or the alcoholism. You know, these doors were open for us. And I can't tell you how thankful I am because I know that I probably would have died. You know, I've been in and out of the hospital probably and suicidal so many times, even this year. And my husband, you know, he has a bad anger problem with, you know, mental health. And, you know, you people helped get us, you know, co-pays on medication, bus tickets to doctors. I would have never, ever been able to do that. And my husband. And it's just God's letting everything just line up perfect, you know, as it is in His Word, you know. And that's why I want to give like you people have given to me. It's touched my heart so much. You know, I don't have any family left. You know, my children are in heaven. But, you know, I am looking so forward to being here at Thanksgiving and volunteering my time because I had a tragedy happen on Thanksgiving before and I didn't want to be thankful. I thought about that. Sometimes the enemy uses that. And I am just so thankful and I'm looking forward. I've met so many friends here that, you know, it's just like family. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's so important for these kids and these teenagers to be taken off the street. You know, we don't want to see these people out in the cold dying and freezing to death. You know, Jesus Christ wants to use us as his people to lift these people up and bring them into the New Life Evangelistic Center.
And you see this as an opportunity and you find it fulfilling to help other people?
Yes, I certainly do.
And you'd encourage...
It has changed my life.
And you'd encourage people that are not volunteering to get involved as volunteers?
Yes, I do.
People can actually have canned food drives at their church. They can go out in the neighborhood and collect canned goods. They can help us to get the food together for Thanksgiving baskets for those that are in need. For Thanksgiving Day, in our City Approved Kitchen, they can come and help us and cook the turkeys and get things ready for a big Thanksgiving dinner. Right now, you could help us. You could actually have a fundraising drive among individuals at your work, as your church, and collect much-needed gifts to New Life Evangelistic Center. You can also give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org with your PayPal, with the PayPal account there, with your credit card. But I don't know if you understand how much every gift is appreciated. The $50 gifts, the $100 gifts, the $25 gifts, every gift is so urgently needed here at New Life Evangelistic Center and so deeply appreciated. And we just want to say thank you. Each one of you that are giving at this moment, each one of you that are caring, and each one that is sharing, so that Tammy and her husband would not have to remain out on the streets, along with the mamas, the babies, the veterans. You see them all coming in here, don't you? People would know where else to go.
We do. People in wheelchairs, people that are sick, people that can't get their insulin any other way. I've seen people, your organization here help so many people. And I didn't even know you had other places around new life for homeless people. And I'm just blessed to be here.
Well, I'm very blessed. I want to say thank you to everybody out there that is donating. Now, if your church is not opening its door, get your church to partner with us. We are co-laborers in the kingdom, not competitors. I mean, there's enough need for everybody out here to go around. And so we need to work together. You can start preparing meals at the church and bring them down. You can take up special offerings, which are urgently needed here at New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. You could get to make care kits up and get a gallon plastic bag and put the toothbrush, toothpaste, razor, deodorant, and soap items in there that we can donate those. I mean, we've been making multiple appeals, but we have not seen a response. And so that's why I must ask you now to please baptize everything in prayer. Please urgently pray for New Life Evangelistic Center at this time and need. The need is great. People are hurting. We're asking you to pray at this particular moment. And you indicated that when you get settled and you get in your own place, you're going to continue to pray for this place and volunteer.
Oh, yes, I am. Volunteer. This place will always be in my life, always. And that comes from my heart,
you
know. And only Jesus can do that.
And Jesus has set you free
from
drugs and alcohol and a self-centered lifestyle and pride in your heart, a love for other people.
Right. And he's healing my marriage every day.
He's healing your marriage every day. That's wonderful. How does it feel to be free?
It feels great.
God is good, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Jesus has come to set the captives free. Maybe you're tormented by worry at this particular time, or depression, or anxiety, or tension. As many as call on the name of the Lord, they shall be called the children of God. Right where you're at, you could just bow your head and just surrender your life to Jesus. You could tell him, Lord, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm tired of a life of sin, selfishness, self-centeredness. I want you, Almighty God. I desire you. Please come into my life and forgive me for my sins. And Jesus, will you be my Lord and Savior? I believe, Jesus, that you died on that cross. You rose from the dead. And I want to experience and receive this eternal life that you have given. And Lord, as you give it to me now, help me to share it with other people, not only in word, but also in deed. Help me, Lord, to love the lost and the lonely and reach out through your love. Many opportunities are given to you here at New Life Evangelistic Center. That's why I want to encourage you to go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and see all the ways that you can let the love and light of Jesus flow through you.